today I've got a wearable makeup tutorial for you, or at least the makeup is wearable. Yeah, I might have already said this in a nail art tutorial, but I actually changed my schedule recently, like from, I think, this week onwards. Instead of doing a makeup tutorial, nail art and tech video, chatting video, DIY video, whatever on Saturday, from now on, every Tuesday we'll have a wearable makeup look, or at least something that I consider wearable. On Thursdays I'll actually have what was originally the Saturday video, which may be about piercings, just a tech video, like I said, just anything I can think of. And on Saturdays we'll have either a nail art or a special effects look. For the simple reason that, well, me personally, I really love doing special effects looks. But I also really love doing normal looks. However, I felt like I was focusing mostly on less wearable looks, whereas I really want to do more of these looks as well, because I do really love doing them, and I also think it's a little bit more useful in a tutorial, because most people will sooner try this than turn themselves into an ice demon on a daily basis. So yeah, this specific look is actually the secondary colors looks that I promised like months ago. Yeah, I did a look with the primary colors like months ago, and then I said I would also use the secondary colors, which is purple, green and orange, and then proceeded to completely forget about it. I sort of did one in autumn because it happened to be very good autumn colors, but that was supposed to be an autumn look and not supposed to be a secondary colors look, so yeah, I really wanted to still do that. So yeah, here's the result. Let's get started. I'm going to start out with priming my eyelids as usual with my Maybelline concealer. It's the 24 hour Superstay concealer. On me it oxidates, and yeah, so I can't use it as a concealer. However, it makes a very nice eye primer, and then I'm just setting it with a powderproof and translucent powder. Powders by Peggy Sage, and yeah, I just prefer to use translucent powder for this, or you know, any loose powder really. Just because I like to apply a lot, just to make sure that nothing can crease, and also so the eyeshadows will blend nicely. Then the eyeshadows I'm going to use are all from the Jeffree Star and Georgina palette, just because it happens to have all the colors I need for this look. And what I'm starting out with is pretty much just putting a base color down. I'm using orange with a large fluffy blending brush. Putting it in the outer corner and almost all the way up to my eyebrow, not completely. And yeah, I'm just trying to mainly center it really at the middle part, pretty much between my lash line and my eyebrows. Then I'm grabbing a smaller blending brush and I'm starting to add the purple. And yeah, really at some point I really wondered, did I just grab the wrong color on accident? Because the purple for some reason turns into the exact same of shade of red of the color that's next to it in the palette when you put it over top of the orange. Which was quite surprising, nevertheless I still like the color, so yeah, whatever, I just went with it. And yeah, I pretty much just applied the purple reddish shade to about halfway into the crease and then filled up the rest towards the inner corner with green. Then I applied a little bit more of orange to blend it out because I felt like the orange wasn't visible enough anymore. Just used a very tiny blender for that, and then I also proceeded to keep adding some color with that tiny blender. I really wanted to keep it like where it was, but I just wanted the colors to be a little bit deeper, so this sort of brush is really perfect for that. Then once I was happy with it, I just blended it all again with the large blender just to make sure that there's no harsh edges. And of course you can just make the colors as intense as you want. You can make it more subtle, or you can make it even more intense by adding more. Then for the eyelid I just went for nude. Just to make sure that my eyelid looks completely even, and yeah. And then I used a little bit more of the orange shade to blend the lid and the outer part of the lid together. And then for the inner corner I went for gold. Yes, I know that's not actually a secondary color, but I just thought it fitted the look and I did want something shiny in the inner corner, seeing as all the other shades are matte. So yeah, for that I'm just using a pencil brush, and then I'm also adding a little bit at the center of the eyelid just to give it a little bit extra, especially in the sunlight. You can't really tell in this lighting. Then for eyeliner I decided to go with my gel eyeliner by Kiko and a nail art brush. The reason I use nail art brushes for things like eyebrows and eyeliner is very simply because I want to be able to make the thinnest possible strokes, and I've never encountered an actual makeup brush that's so thin. So yeah, I just go with nail art brushes. And I just get them off eBay, like they're really cheap and they last for years and years and years. So I think that's a pretty good deal. And yeah, of course you can do your eyeliner however you want. So I decided to go with just a simple eyeliner, thinner in the inner corner, then thicker towards the wing. And then just a wing that's, you know, there, but not too much. Then for lashes, I went with either eBay or Eylure lashes. The box is Eylure, but I just stuffed all the lashes I had in there. So yeah, I don't know what brand it actually is. And the lash glue is by Peggy Sage. I recently tinted my eyelashes again. I really want to start doing that again because it's just very easy, especially on working days. I don't have to add mascara or anything. But also when I'm wearing falsies, they're already black. My natural lashes, when they're tinted, black, obviously. So I don't need to use mascara. But of course, if you don't tint your eyelashes, you can just use mascara first and then apply falsies. Then for my waterline, I'm using Black and Black by Estée Lauder as usual. Well, as usual when I'm painting my waterline black at least. I'm actually trying out a different one, a more affordable one, right now. Literally right now while I'm doing this voiceover. But yeah, if it works as well as I hope it will, then you'll definitely see it in a video soon. The Kiko gel liner also stays in place all day, by the way, but I can't manage to paint it on my waterline without painting my contact lenses along, so I just decided to not try that anymore, for the sake of my contact lenses. And then for my face, I started out with primer. I'm going for Catrice foundation and concealer today, so I decided to go with the Catrice primer as well. This is the Prime and Fine primer. I think they still sell it. I bought it ages ago. I've been really trying lately to use a primer that's from the same brand as the foundation I'm using. Simply because those are meant to work together, so I do actually feel like it works better. I still don't know if you're supposed to shake the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. But I just figure I'll shake it anyway, because I'm not sure and it's so liquidy. And yeah, I just applied it and then blended it out with the Beauty Blender. You could get this to be completely full coverage with a brush. With a Beauty Blender, it's still, I'd say, medium to full coverage. Which I didn't want on my lips. But it's slightly more natural. And yeah, I was just going out shopping with friends today when I did this makeup. So I didn't want to be all full coverage. Besides, I feel like my skin likes it better when it's not completely stuffed with makeup, surprisingly. Then, if my camera will focus on me, we're going to contour. This time I'm using the Sculpting Touch Contour Stick by Kiko. I can't remember the number of this. They had two different ones when I was in the store, when I bought this. But I'll just put it down below in the description box as always. So you can easily look it up. Along with anything else I used. And yeah, just painting that all over my face. It's very nice and creamy, which I really, really like. And then I'm just using my Beauty Blender to blend it all out. It's also really easy to blend, but if you, like me, do your entire face first and then start blending it out, you do need to work quite quickly, because once it sets and it's not going to move anymore. So yeah, this will have to work quite hard on my cheeks. Next time I'll probably just, you know, apply it and immediately blend it out. Put a spot on my face, instead of doing my whole face at once. Then for my brows, I started out with the L'Oreal Brow Plumper. Just to make sure that even if there is a complete volcano, my eyebrow hairs will stay glued in place. This stuff is really, really, really strong, which I think is a good thing. And then while that's drying, I'm going to do my concealer first. I'm using the Catrice Liquid Camouflage. Liquid Camouflage. I'm not sure what it was called, again, it's in the description box. But it's my favorite concealer. It's just, like, it doesn't crease on me, it doesn't oxidate. It's just a beautiful shade, and it is a very high coverage, so yeah, I'm really happy with it. And I'm also using it as a highlighter on my nose. And a little bit on my chin as well, and just blending it out with a Beauty Blender. And then for powder, I'm again using my Powder Puff and Loose Translucent Powder by Peggy Sage. Powder Puff is also by Peggy Sage, by the way. And I decided to try my hand at baking once again. I don't usually do this, but I always feel like cream contours are just a little bit less, I don't know, a little bit less obviously there than, you know, powder contour. So I wanted it to stand out a little bit more. I wanted it to look a little bit more
sharp, I guess. So I decided to do baking, and while the powder is sitting on my face, I'm filling in my eyebrows. Using the NYX Tamer Frame Brow Pomade for that, and another newer brush. This one is slightly bigger than the one I used for my eyeliner. But again, it's really, really thin, so I can really make hair strokes with it. However, I was going shopping the day when I filmed this with friends, like I think I said before. And I was sort of in a hurry, so I decided to just fill them in quite harshly rather than very natural, because I don't know how it is for other people, but for me, filling my eyebrows in naturally just takes me way more time than filling them in quite harshly, so yeah, they became quite painted. And then once I was done with my eyebrows, I just brushed off the excess powder with a tiny face brush. And then proceeded to do the rest of my face with a large powder brush. I'm also doing my eyebrows because I really notice when I use cream products or pencils and I put powder on my eyebrows as well, it really lasts all day, even when it's raining. So yeah, since I noticed that, I am actually pretty serious about actually putting powder on my eyebrows every day. Then I wear makeup in the first place. Then for blush, I'm using a purple brush, purple burgundy-ish by Isorché. This is Rose Hortensia. Very nice buildable color. And then for highlighter, I wanted something sparkly because the eyes are quite matte other than the inner corners. So I went for the Catrice High Glow Highlighter with a small brush. If you want this more subtle, you could use a fan brush. And yeah, if you're not into glitter, I can recommend the Kiko highlighters. But yeah, I just felt like glitter today. I really like glitter, so I just stuffed glitter all over my face. It's something I regularly do. And then I finished up my eyes with some eyeshadow. I'm using a pencil brush. Sort of a very pointed pencil brush to put the purple shade in the outer corners. And then I'm blending it out using the green and a slightly more fluffy blending brush. Pencil brush. Blah. Yeah. The sharper one is by BH Cosmetics. And this one is by Sigma. Then I did decide to use some mascara on my lower lashes. Even though I tinted them as well. Compared to the top lashes with the falsies on top of it. They were just not noticeable enough. And yes, I just noticed what a weird face I pull when I do my mascara. Then I decided it stood out a little bit too much, so I went over it with a spoolie. Just to take a little bit of product off, and then it's time for the lips. I'm going for nude today, because when I go out shopping, I don't want to have to worry about how my lip color looks. And if a nude fades, it's just going to stay nude, so that's fine. Pencil I'm using is by Peggy Sage. I really have to keep reminding myself to actually not lean down too far when I do my lips. And the lipstick actually managed to stay on all day, which I was quite surprised about. It's Maroon by Catrice. I don't know, I use it quite often, yet I never really pay much attention to how well it lasts. But yeah, to me it's just a perfect shade of nude. It's not too pale, because really pale nudes just don't look nice on me. And this one is warm, not too dark, not too pale. It's just, to me it's perfect. And as always, I dab my lips with my fingers, just to make sure that there's no excess product. I really feel like that makes the lipstick last longer. And then I decided to go for setting spray. I don't really feel like it makes a difference in how matte my makeup stays. But it does prevent it from going powdery. And no, I'm not one of those people who loves putting on setting spray. I very much hate spraying stuff at my face. But yeah, I do like how just natural and healthy and just nice it makes my foundation look. I do always dab it in with a beauty blender. Just again to make sure there's no excess products. And yeah, then the entire look is done. And despite it looking quite complicated with the different colors, it's actually really, really easy to do. And yeah, that's really a sort of look that I really love when going out shopping. Something that looks way more complicated than it actually is.
So, here's the final results. Admittedly, the purple actually turned sort of red, probably because I put it over the orange, which was quite unexpected. Nevertheless, I do actually really like how this turned out. I'm actually quite surprised by how well the green and the purple-red shade blended. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you'd like to, you can also subscribe to my channel. Other than that, for now, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!